Hands-on with the Moto G 3rd generation smartphone. The term game changer is overused these days, but the Moto G 2, 2014, and the original Moto G earned that title. It's the most fitting way to describe phones that redefined our expectations of what a budget phone can deliver. Those subtle changes start up front, where Motorola is sticking to the same 5-inch 720p HD screen as the focal point. It might have been ambitious to expect a full HD 1080p screen here, but 720p is slowly becoming the norm at this end of the market. Lining it up against the screen on last year's Moto G and you'd be hard-pressed to notice any differences. It's still not an exceptionally bright screen, but images remain sharp, colors are generally accurate and viewing angles are decent as well. Again, there's not physical buttons here with a slim screen bezel down the sides of the screen and the two front-facing speakers above and below the screen. The speaker segments are narrower in comparison to the Moto G2, and the way designed might make them even more prone to trapping bits of fluff and detritus. We'll look out for this in our full review. Around the sides, there's a faux metal finish that's not as tacky as it sounds, while the volume rocker and standby button remain in the same place on the right edge. It's the same story for the micro USB charging port, which sits at the bottom of the phone and the headphone jack. It's when you wrap your hand around the new Moto G that you notice why it's a different prospect to hold. The new Moto G has that curved plastic back, but there's now a significantly more textured finish that's far more grippy than the soft touch finish on last year's Moto G. It's also more Moto X-like in looks with the silver accent around the camera and flash along with a more pronounced curved edge on the top end of the phone. I was a fan of the soft touch finish, but this is by no means a backward step and still helps make it feel like a more expensive phone. The back is once again removable and that's where you'll find the non-removable 2470mAh battery, single micro SIM card slot and micro SD card slot to expand storage. Motorola is offering the Moto G in 8GB and 16GB versions, so that should let you add another 32GB of space to save your videos, photos, and apps. Keeping up with the Moto X-inspired features, Motorola is offering the Moto Maker option for the Moto G as well, so you can chop and change the backs and accents featured around the camera with different colors and textures. This will inevitably push the price of the handset up, though, so that's worth keeping in mind. While it seems like everyone apart from Sony is ditching waterproof phones, Motorola has decided to join the party late. The Moto G is IPX7 certified, which means you can submerge it in water up to 1 meter for 30 minutes. Fortunately, there was a water tank to test this out and while it was submerged for 30 minutes, I can confirm that after a few minutes in the tank, it was still in working order. On the software front, Motorola is shipping the G with Android 5.1.1 Lollipop, so it's as up-to-date as you can get until Android M ships later this year. There's the more actionable notifications on the lock screen and redesigned settings in the notification drop-down menu. This is a pure Android experience with just a handful of Motorola apps, like the Useful Assist, to set up different phone profiles. Keeping things running smoothly is a suitably mid-range chipset with the Moto G upgrading 1.4 GHz quad-core Snapdragon 410 processor. There's 1GB and 2GB RAM options, so if you like to multitask, you should be catered for. I couldn't get the Geekbench 3 up and running to grab some benchmark scores, but I did manage some gaming and watch some video and there was no lag or issues with the performance. This year, Motorola is making a big deal about the cameras on its phone and that's not just for the more expensive Moto X Play and Moto X Style. Apparently it's based around the camera used in the Nexus 6 and it's moving up from an 8-megapixel to a 13-megapixel sensor with a f/2.0 lens and a color-correlated temperature, CCT, flash to help capture more balanced images. There's other improvements, too, like an improved lens system to capture less noise and a multi-IR filter to reduce glare. The last big thing to talk about here is battery life. Motorola has upgraded to a 2,470 mAh battery, which is up from the 2,070 mAh inside last year's Moto G. That should get you 24 hours in mixed use. Disappointingly, it does miss out on the turbocharging feature, which appears on the Moto X Style and Play, so it'll take a little longer to get a decent battery boost if you've forgotten to charge it the night before. But it's large battery, so we expect very good battery life from the new Moto G. First impressions. From what I've seen of the Moto G 2015, so far, Motorola looks set to cement its place as the best of the budget phone maker. Most of the Moto X-inspired design changes are welcome ones, and the 720p HD screen is still a solid performer. Some will love the fact that's it waterproof and others simply won't care. Crucially, it hasn't had an impact on the look and the feel of the handset, and that's a good thing. There's no real surprises on the processor front, and the extra bit of battery Motorola has added can only help push playtime a little further. My reservations lie with the camera right now, something that Motorola has championed this year but which doesn't make a good first impression. Overall, there's enough improvements here to suggest it'll be a worthwhile upgrade on its predecessor once again, just like the Moto G 2014 was on the original Moto G.